Hello everyone and welcome to Maple Leaf ESL. My name is Andrew and thank you for joining me here today. For today's lesson, I want to take a look at phrasal verbs that use the expression call, okay? And for this lesson, I've chosen about 7 different phrasal verbs, and as always, we're going to look at definitions and many examples, okay? So let's see if we can start the lesson here. So it says the first one, call for, and we've got 2 definitions. The first one says to require or demand and to make necessary. Okay, think about this situation. Imagine I'm sitting with my friends and one of my friends says, I have some big news, I'm getting married, okay? All right, so my response to this might be, okay, well, this calls for a celebration, or this calls for a bottle of champagne, okay? So what that means is this situation now demands that we celebrate, or it demands that we get a bottle of champagne, right? So if you say this calls for a celebration, or this calls for a toast, right? Remember, a toast means a speech to somebody, usually at a wedding or at a party, right? If you make a toast, you're making a nice speech about somebody. So if I say this calls for a toast, that means this situation demands that I make a speech, right? That I make a toast, right? So commonly you say this calls for a celebration, or this calls for, again, something nice. The second definition there says to summon or request someone, right? Remember, summon means that you want somebody to come to you, right? Okay, so maybe if I'm at a party and I'm a little drunk, I might call for a taxi, right? Or if I'm really sick or injured, I might call for an ambulance, right? If I'm wealthy and I have my own driver, right? This person drives my car for me. We can call that a chauffeur. I might call for my chauffeur, okay? A boss or a manager in a company might call for a meeting, right? Or call everyone for a meeting. Again, that means they're gonna request everyone come to the meeting, or summon everyone to the meeting. So call everyone for the meeting, right? Okay, next one there says call back, and it says to return a phone call. Okay, that one's pretty simple. If somebody calls me and I miss the phone call, then later I will call that person back, right? Or maybe I do get the phone call, but I'm busy. So I might say, sorry, I'm busy. Can I call you back later, right? So that one's pretty easy. Okay, the second definition for this one says to recall a damaged product for repair. Okay, think about this situation. Imagine a car company, they produce many cars. Okay, let's imagine they produced 100,000 cars for this one model. Okay, but actually, there was some damage on this product. Okay, let's say the brakes were damaged on all of these cars, right? All 100,000 of these cars. So now the car company must call back 100,000 cars. So again, that means they have to recall or get back all of these cars because they're damaged and they need to repair them or they need to fix them. So they've called back 100,000 cars or something like that. Okay, next one says call off, and the definition is to cancel something. Okay, this one's also pretty simple. Okay, if I call off the meeting, that means I'm canceling the meeting. If I call off my vacation, then I'm canceling my vacation. Okay, imagine 2 people are getting married, but then they fight, and now they've canceled the wedding. So we can say the wedding has been called off, right? So anytime something's canceled, we can say it's been called off, right? Imagine there's a sports game, but it's raining, so they can't play the game. So the game has been called off. Okay, next one says call in. We've got 2 definitions. The first one says to report or inform by phone. Okay, the best example, think about a reporter, okay? Maybe a reporter works for a TV station, okay? And this reporter is out doing research, right? Now they wanna call their boss and sort of maybe give an update to their boss. So they might call in to the TV station and give an update, right? Because again, when you call in, you're gonna report to somebody or inform somebody of something by phone. So if the reporter calls into the station, this means she's gonna make a report or inform her boss. So something like that. So anytime you call into your company, you're calling in with a reason, right? To give an update or to inform somebody of something. Okay, the next one says to summon for consultation or help. Okay, imagine this. Imagine the police, they have a murder. Okay, there's a big murder scene. Okay, but they realize this is actually a really important murder scene. They can't deal with it. This is actually a murder for the FBI to deal with because it's an international thing or it's a big thing. So the police will call in the FBI, right? Because they need help from the FBI. They can't do it. Okay, or imagine somebody has a problem, but they can't deal with the problem. They need a lawyer. So they will call in the lawyer to help with this. Okay, or again, one more example. Imagine a company, they have a problem with their electricity, right? The electricity's not working. Okay, and nobody is trained to do this in the company, right? And also it's a little dangerous. So they're gonna call in an electrician, right? That's a professional, right? They need to call in a professional. Okay, a few more here. Next one says to call someone up, and it says there to contact someone by phone. Okay, this is simple. This is just the same as call somebody. If I'm gonna call my friend Dave, I can say, I'm gonna call up my friend Dave, right? Or if I'm gonna order a pizza, I might say, let's call up the pizza place. You know, that's the same thing as let's call the pizza place, right? So that one's pretty easy. Okay, another definition there says to be brought up to a higher level. Okay, when I think of this meaning of to call someone up, I think of two different situations. I can think of sports and I think of the military. Okay, if someone is called up to the military, that means they've been called into service for the military. So now they're gonna be working for the military, right? Okay, same thing in sports. If you are called up, it means you're going to be brought up to the next highest level, right? So in North America, if there's a baseball player and he's playing in the minor leagues, right? Remember, the minor leagues is below the major leagues, right? Major League Baseball is the highest level. So if he's playing in the minor leagues and he's been called up, this means he's being brought up to the next level, right? To the major leagues. So if somebody says, I was called up to the big leagues, this means they're being brought up to a higher level in that professional sport, okay? All right, next one says call out, and the definition is to shout or speak in a loud voice, okay? If I yell out, John, John, right? I'm calling out John's name, right? So in this case, I'm just shouting out his name or yelling his name, right? So if you call out something, it just means you're shouting something or you're yelling something in a loud voice, okay? So that one's pretty easy. Okay, last one here, it says to call someone out, okay? And this is a slang expression, but it's very common. It says to challenge someone or to criticize someone's behavior or actions, okay? All right, if we think about social media, like Facebook, you know, or Twitter, it's really easy to call someone out, okay? Think about a famous person has made some negative comments. Maybe they're racist comments or sexist comments. Then many people, they go to social media and they call that person out, okay? That means they criticize this person for their opinion or for their action or for their behavior, right? So they're calling that person out. Okay, this also, as it says there, to challenge someone, if I call someone out, that could also mean that I've challenged to fight this person, right? If somebody, let's say there's somebody and he's maybe causing trouble with my girlfriend or with my wife, okay, and if I call this person, I say, hey buddy, I'm calling you out. That means I'm ready to fight you, right? I wanna punch you or something like that, Okay? So to call somebody out is to challenge somebody, or again, to criticize their actions or their opinions or their behavior. Okay? All right, I want to see if we can erase the whiteboard and let's take a look at some written examples using each of these phrasal verbs. Okay, let's look at this first example. So it says that you're having a baby. This calls for a celebration, right? So remember, that means this situation demands a celebration, okay? Next one, I'm tired. I think we should call for a taxi, right? So I think we should summon a taxi or request a taxi. Okay, next, I'm at work. Can you call me back later, right? Can you return my phone call later? Okay, next one. The IT company has to call back 10,000 defective products, right? So they have to recall 10,000. Remember, just defective just means like damaged or broken products, okay? Next one, if the rain doesn't stop, we might have to call off the wedding, right? Cancel the wedding. Okay, I need to call in and talk to my boss, right? So again, if we call in, we're sort of reporting to someone or sort of, you know, checking in with someone. Okay, next, there are too many insects. We need to call in the exterminator, right? Remember, the exterminator is a professional who kills bugs or who kills insects, right? So we can't do it, so we need to call in someone else, right? Call in the exterminator. Okay, let's call up Jamie, see if he wants to hang out, right? So remember, that's just the same. Let's call Jamie, let's call up Jamie. Okay, next one, did you hear? Tim got called up to the big leagues, right? So Tim is moving up to a higher professional level, right? So he got called up to the big leagues, right? Okay, next one. Did someone just call out my name, right? Maybe I heard my name, somebody shouted it, somebody yelled it. Okay, and last one here. Many people are calling out the president for his negative comments about gay marriage, right? So maybe the president, he made negative comments, right? So now people are criticizing him, right? Or they're challenging him because he made these negative comments and they are not happy about it, okay? All right, that is the end of today's lesson. I hope all of my examples were clear and easy to follow. Thank you so much for joining me here at Maple Leaf ESL, and I look forward to seeing you again next time.